In this video, I'll be going through my process of bringing this Photoshop illustration to life using After Effects. I will be splitting this video into 5 parts, from the illustration process to getting it ready for animation, hair animation using AFP hair script, other animations, and then making it extra fun by adding objects getting sliced up. The illustration itself was a continuation of my lamb artist study video, so if you want to know how to draw in this style, check out that video. Since the idea was to animate a sword unsheathing, I started by drawing roughs of the sword's closed version and open version. So after I'm happy with the composition, the next step is to refine the rough. I started by redrawing the line art, then adding base colors. The next step was to block in the shadows, and using a clipping mask, add halftones to those shadows. Since this illustration was inspired by Lam's artworks, I wanted to add tons of bold graphic elements in the form of pins and badges. These were done using Adobe Illustrator, using the Shape Builder tool, and then scattered these elements around the composition, making sure that they are not too cluttered. And that was basically the main process of this illustration. And the final process is to add details and refine the illustration. And this was the outcome of this stage. And only after finishing this illustration that I've realized that I might have made a slight mistake. Yeah, my layers were merged. Everything was merged. So in hindsight, splitting them will probably save a lot of time down the line. Before splitting the layers, let me show you my epic animation plan. So what I wanted from this animation is for the hair to be moved by the wind, eyes to blink, sword to be able to open and close, and the sleeves and keychain to swing around in the wind. Once I have this rough idea of how things will move, I then start this boring process of splitting the parts into its own layers. I ended up having to cut each part out using the lasso tool and redrawing most of them. I also made sure to redraw the previously hidden parts of the hair. In the end, I had 12 different parts for the hair. Here, the sleeves had to be extended slightly for the swinging animation. The toughest part was having to redraw and redesign previously hidden parts like the shoulder, the shirt, and the blade of the katana. Overall, this process will be different for each artwork, but it's quite straightforward. Also, if you split layers at the beginning, then you wouldn't have to do all of this. Once everything is ready, I then imported the Photoshop files into After Effects. Ever since seeing those League of Legends loading screen process videos, I've always wanted to try animating my own illustrations, but I thought that hair was going to be insanely difficult to do, so I never attempted this. That was until I found out about AFP HairRig script. If you want to animate hair in After Effects, then AFP HairRig script is the way to go. This was my first time using the script, and I'm honestly surprised by how fast and easy it was to do the hair. I watched this 30 minutes video to learn the script, but you really only have to watch 5 minutes of the video for the fundamentals. So here's what I did for my hair animation. I put around 5 to 8 puppet pins per strip of hair. For the base or the parts that you want to stay still, remove the keyframe. In the effect controls panel, change puppet engine to legacy. This is required for the script to work, but I have no idea what it does. Run the script and yeah, that's it. I repeated this process for 12 of my hair layers, and with that, you've animated the hair. To save time, you can also run the script once you've pinned all the hair. However, there were some minor bugs that I encountered. Sometimes there's this issue where not every pixel is included in the mesh. This often happens to thinner parts of the illustration. To solve this, all you have to do is mask out the shape of the illustration. This was done to make sure that the mesh will cover every area of the hair. Then you can continue with your usual steps of putting in puppet pins. The last thing I did was to adjust the intensity of the animation. For this, I changed the amplitude in the master control. Also, my first time that I did all this, this happened. I have no idea what I did to create this monstrosity. I also could not fix this no matter what. And since I didn't have a backup version, I had to redo the entire hair. So I would highly recommend to save backups along the way. I'll briefly go through the other animated parts in this illustration. First is the background. Move the pattern from here to here. And then I use the loop out expression to create an endless loop effect. Sword unsheathing animation, just two different layers moving apart. I keyframed the position and adjusted the curves. The part I had the most fun with was this blade highlight. Blade highlight was actually animated frame by frame in Photoshop. I wanted to try mixing traditional animation to After Effects animation, which surprisingly worked really well. And after refining and adding colors to the animation, I imported it into After Effects and slapped it onto the blade. The swinging sleeves and keychains were also animated using AFP Hair Script. The string of the keychain, however, was run with the null as a bone structure instead of pins. Basically, what this allows me to do is to be able to link the mascot to the lower null of the string, and then link the top null of the string to the sword. Now when the sword moves, the string and the mascot moves together. I then adjusted the amplitude to mimic the momentum and inertia of a swinging keychain. This part for me is trial and error. I adjusted until I got something somewhat realistic. Mouth was quite messy, but I think I was able to get away with animating using puppet pins. For the eyes, I started by animating the eyelash closing using puppet pins and used scale to flip it upside down. I did the same thing for the eyelid. Then pre-comp the eyeball and mask out parts to match the eye closing. Inside of the eye comp are these highlights, which I made them wiggle using wiggle expressions. I then added rotation to the star highlight as the eye opens. Then duplicated everything to create the eye on the other side. And here's the outcome of this process. So at this point, I'm really happy with the outcome and it's pretty much finished. But then I had another idea.
There are mountains that a samurai must climb.
I saw a clip of this psychopathic streamer playing a game called Rhythm Heaven. There's this section where the character slices monsters in half. As I watched this clip, I thought, what the hell is wrong with this guy? But I also thought, oh, let's try putting that into my illustration, which I think would fit really nicely since everything is so playful. I started by designing the objects that would be sliced up. I decided to create pixel art characters using pencil tools in Photoshop. Then converted them into vectors in Adobe Illustrator and made a slice effect. Split them into two. In the end, I ended up with four parts for each target. Then imported everything into After Effects. And after some testing, I decided that the slice effect would show up for three frames. Then afterwards, the two layers split and falls downwards at different speed, with the lower part falling faster than the top part, just like the enemies in Rhythm Heaven. Put everything into the main composition, then animated the position of the object to make it seem like it's been tossed. And that's everything. The end result was this super playful animation, with flowy hair and clothes as supporting secondary animation, which I think helps pull everything together and make this animation very organic and lively. If you want to see more of these illustration animation process videos, subscribe and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching.